I just wanted to show this setup, what I'm messing around with at the moment. Basically a Tesla coil. I'll go over and explain what I've got. The top two rings are capacitor rings, which are connected to ground, connected to the bottom of the secondary into ground. Through the tap on that coil underneath, which doesn't actually do a great deal. But anyway, it goes to ground and out through this connection to the ground stake. The top of the secondary, these two top rings, capacitor rings, are connected to the top of the secondary, and of course the bottom of the secondary is connected over there by that green wire. The primary is two turns, it's the center tap. This is the center, which goes down through this coil through the tap to the center tap of the supply, which is where the ground for the blue trace of the scope is. The yellow trace of the scope is a probe there hanging about 90 millimeters away from the side of the secondary. To explain the primary circuit, each side is connected to the respective sides of the supply transformer. Between the center tap and there is the resonance cap for each turn of the secondary on each side, and the other caps are the series caps, which I'll show on a drawing, which I've disconnected from the supply circuit and connected a lead, so which is the green and the red leads there. Scope's connected to the primary. One primary and the center tap. The function generator is driving the opposite side primary. So on the drawing, I'm disconnected from the supply at this point and this point from the spark gaps, and driving this side of this series cap with the function generator. The negative of the function generator doesn't even need to be connected at this frequency. I'm using a square wave input, AC input. The scope probe is connected at this point, this being the two turn primary with the center tap, and the scope probe ground is connected to the center tap there. Yeah. Okay, it's about 1008 kilocycles, square wave input. I'll go ahead and crank up the input voltage to full on the function generator. You can see there, I'm going to light the neon. If I get a good enough connection, I'm not getting into the field. And when I do that, of course, expect my voltage there. Okay, so I'll go ahead and okay. So as we can see there, got resonance about with the opposite phase thing about 1453 kilohertz, and we've got it in a regular mode there at around about 1 megahertz. And so if I wind the frequency right back, adjust the frequency back to 490 or so. You can see there they're picking up harmonic, which is considering the circuit's being driven, it's not too bad. And so we'll go down to 1/3 of 1/3. See a much stronger effect on the voltage at 333 kilohertz. And of course, if we wanted to have a look down even further and see that 200. Well, that's a reaction. Kilohertz. can see though that when you hit the real resonance, it's a completely different thing. The difference between the different wave shape inputs is a triangle wave input, sine wave input, square wave input. I think the difference in the amplitude of the waveforms is a result of the area of the waveforms. Just looking at it roughly.